Hi everyone, my name is Robert Capel. I am the founder of Arms of Love Emotional Care Service. We are an emotional care service that helps senior citizens and mentally disabled children in Cleveland, Ohio. Through the social media, we wish to impact great learning experience of nonprofits in Cleveland, Ohio. Today, we have the pleasure of working with Trials for Hope. They are a nonprofit organization that helps serve senior citizens in the Cleveland community by delivering household goods, meats, foods, household essentials. Today, we had the pleasure of working with them, walking around and seeing their experience, and we hope to shine a light on their organization because they really are great. Today, we're at Trials for Hope. It is a nonprofit organization here in Cleveland, Ohio. I've worked with them for about 3 or 4 times now. They're great people. This organization helps senior citizens and mentally disabled people.
These are household bags. It's got toiletries, toilet paper, paper towels, laundry detergent, dish detergent, hand sanitizer, just basic stuff that they can use. They can't leave the house or wherever they're at to go and get themselves because they just aren't able to. They're older, they're handicapped, they can't get out to help themselves, so we help them.
How did this come about? You have all these trial products that we're seeing here.
Trials for Hope came up because I had a donation of trial-sized toiletries. When you live outside, you cannot carry a full bottle of shampoo and a full tube of toothpaste very easily in your pocket. But you can carry a mini-sized bar of soap. You can go to the bathroom anywhere and at least do a wash-up. Trial-sized toiletries, toilet paper, household cleaner, none of that's covered by food stamps. So the issue is if you have no money and you can't get this on food stamps, then how do you take care of yourself with dignity? Dignity isn't supposed to be a luxury, and for many people it is, unless you know the facilities that will give it out. So we give it out.
What was your first brand that you started with?
I was volunteering at a community center and they gave me the toiletries, and then I ordered them online. The next thing we started giving out was canned goods because 1 out of every 5 people in Ohio are hungry.
We have people that come and pick up every day, pick up groceries, you know, not just the hundreds of people we go to. You know, we have people actually come and get stuff.
And so that's every class for every student in school. You have people, at least 2 or 3 people, that don't have enough to eat. And they don't talk about it because who wants to say, my parents don't make enough? There's a lot of shame with hunger. There's a lot of shame with being on food stamps. Instead of it being something to help people, it helps people, but they're very quiet. People want to be independent, but not everyone has the luxury of finding a job because of their record or because of other issues that they might suffer with. There's a lot of challenges that are easily taken for granted for people who have an education and money because they don't experience what other people do. And that's not a shame factor, that's an awareness factor.
Started working with Trials of Hope?
About 2 months ago. Oh no, about a month and a half ago.
Why did you start?
Well, I came by and I talked to the pastor. And Matt, it was a sunny day and I was riding my bike. And we kept talking and everything. Our kids started coming. They let me in here because it was cold outside. I was homeless. And so they let me start coming in and stuff. Next thing I know, they hired me.
Well, 11 years ago in June, every day I've been at this, trying to create something with other people that offered unity and offered opportunities and encouraged dignity and encouraged hope.
that they saved my life this winter. You know, I'd approach that doctor without the sleeping bags and the blankets, stuff like that. They gave me a stove, heater, you know, and stuff for my tent and all that. So,
what is the main reason you started this?
Yeah, the whole main thing was when I took it to a community meal, and some of the people in the meal are on subsidized incomes, people loved the fact that they were thought about. So the whole reason and all this was it helped people feel better. Kind of like a spiritual high that an act of kindness could make such a difference. And things came to me that I didn't ask for to help people, and it made a difference for them. So I followed.
Yeah.
And I'm still following.
Do you think as when you were growing up, did you envision yourself doing this while you were older?
No. When I was growing up, there was a long time that I was deeply suffering with depression. I was suffering with anxiety, and I was beginning to suffer with some other issues and habits, and my goal wasn't to stay around. My goal was basically to end it. I thought that I was done, and God had other plans.
Each person gets one, only if they're homebound, not a family. I don't know if I have enough for a family. I'll find out when we get this. You want water?
Well, yeah.
Dave, how long you've been helping out?
Not long enough.
What, about 3 years with you?
Yeah, Dave is why we can do shut-ins, because him or Dennis, they get it done. The guys could help if they had to, but this makes it so much easier on everyone. And Dave and Dennis are the bomb.com. They are so humble to give up their time to do this. It's pretty amazing twice a month to take time out in the middle of your day to help some people.
And it is great.
And he won't let me give him gas money, but I'm working on it.
I always tell him God pays better than John Gray.
Yeah, John Gray's pretty cheap, that son of a... Yeah, Dave's very, very humble.
Yeah, I don't get the candle on.
On the other side, Miss Gloria is out of the hospital, but I don't know if she's walking. We just have to get the food for them. We need a set of three purple bags, three meats, three things.
You need another house?
No, I need one more house.
I got it. You need another meat?
Yeah. Hey now, we are here at your door with food.
What you're doing.
Okay, so we come to the community and we serve twice a month. We have seniors who are homebound, which means they can't really go outside their home easy. And then we just have older seniors. Hey now, I'll be right there. And we make sure people get a little more of a basic needs so they don't have to worry about it. When you're older, no one wants to worry about, do I have toilet paper? Do I have something to eat later for the day? So our goal is to improve the quality. Hey now, how are you? Good, we have some Easter candy for you.
I'm glad.
I know. It's always a good time for chocolate. Don't get me started.
We thank you for learning a little about us, for seeing some of our journey. This is a journey every day for us. Besides thanking you for learning about us, it doesn't take a lot to make a difference, but you have to start. It's not the biggest gestures that make a difference. It's taking the time for someone else. Time is something that you cannot replace, so make it worthwhile. We celebrate you for following us again, and we hope you have a great day.
Tell him that's the mission. Yeah. Tell him that's the vision.